Everyone, welcome back to Diana, my channel. My name is Yanni, and of course, Diana and I'm so happy you are here. We have some new DIYs for you. We hope you enjoy a little bit of fun, a little bit of chaos, and our DIYs are always very easy to make. So if you like this content, I hope you will consider subscribing to Diana, my channel. And for now, let's jump into our first DIY. So for this DIY, you see, we don't need a lot of things. We need, I use at least a glass container. You can use a square bowl. You can use whatever you like, but I use the glass one. I use some coasters, some cork coasters, and of course some twine. I use this twine, but you can use a thicker, you can use a little bit thinner, you can use anything you like. And of course, not to forget our glue gun. Some people use some Mod Podge to glue their rope on their items, but I always prefer my glue gun. So this is what we're going to use for this DIY. So we're going to start with our glass container, and but this one is so very easy. And even you can do it with a plastic box you have laying around where you can do your food in. It doesn't matter, just it has a little bit of this shape. And of course you can also use a round shape. What I'm going to do, I'm going to do some glue gun. I'm going to do some glue a little bit under here, because I want to make a first start over here. And I'm just laying my rope in it, and I'm just waiting until it is dry, because or else I am just pulling everything away again. So I'm going to make a first layer a little bit on the underside of your little container, and I'm just trying to do it as low as I can, just to get also our twine as low as we can. So I'm going to turn it around, and I'm going to do the other side. And you see, it is very easy. You just have to work a little bit with it, because glass is always very smooth, so you probably is a little bit difficult to get it stuck, your glue stuck on it. Oh my English, yo. You see already, I am just doing a little bit over here, a little bit more, and I'm just going to use the underside, just try to get as low as you can, and just wait for a moment until everything is dry. And now we almost have our first layer of our twine. So you see, it's very easy even for me. And we are going, after that we are going to do a part higher. So first we're going to do this over here, and just squeeze it a little bit, and now we're going to turn, and now we're going to do the layer exactly on top of the other one. But I think you already know what I mean if you work a little bit more with twine. So I'm going to do the rest, and if I am almost there, I show you how it turned out. So you see already, I already have four turns on my little glass container, and I'm just going to make the glue stripes as thin as I can, and I'm just going to squeeze them a little bit against the layer under it to get a little bit of the cleaner look, because we don't want to have glue everywhere. So you see, every time I'm squeezing it a little bit and just turn it around again, just pulling your rope away and just putting a fine line with my glue gun, at least as fine as I can do it with my glue gun. Then very careful, just lay your twine over the next layer and just squeeze it again. And so you see, you get a nice, a clean, clean look. And I'm going to do it a little bit until here, and then we are going to stop, and then we are going to further to do a little piece on the top of it. So we have a middle with some glass still, and then later on, We will see how we are going to decorate it, or maybe I have another idea for it. But right now I'm going to do a little bit further, but I just wanted to show you how easy it is just to do layer by layer on top of your twine. So you see already I did the first part of my container, and what I'm going to do right now is just glue the first also a little in between, and then we are going to do the next layer of our twine around here, and then we're going to do it on the opposite, so we get two pieces of twine, and then we later on we're going to see what we're going to do in the middle. But first I'm going to do the top layer. Here you see how he is turned out, and I am really happy how he's looking. The only thing I am not so happy about, and of course I should have known, if you do glass, it's always see-through. So what I didn't realize is that you still can see the glue spots if you leave a piece open, and of course I don't really like that. So what I'm going to try to do is just take some furniture wax, and I'm going to distress the outside. So the little bit of the glue will disappear, and then I'm going to think about the inside, and of course I'm going to try to do some little fairy tale lights inside of here, and just looking how this is will look like inside, or else I'm going to paint them inside. I have to think about it, but first I'm going to distress it with some furniture wax. So you see I'm just taking a little bit of furniture wax, not a lot. Only a little bit, and just wipe it away. Of course I have my pot in front of you, you won't even see it. So I'm just dabbing it off a little bit more, and I'm going to try to give it especially a little bit inside, a little bit of the darker brown color. I need a little bit more wax because I thought it would cover it a little bit better, but it doesn't do it the greatest. So I'm going to work a little bit with it to make it a little look more like a rustic color, and then I show you how it's look like and what I'm going to do next. Here you see how he is turning out with a little piece of wax on it. What I'm was thinking about, because I want to have lights inside of it, and you always say with the battery package, it's always if you're laying down inside of here, you always see the plastic package because for the batteries, and I don't really like that. So I was thinking, what can I do to give it a little bit more? I thought of painting this this piece inside of here, but paint is not always you have to have a really straight line if it will look okay. So what did I do? I ordered already a couple of weeks ago, I ordered some velvet black ribbon. So, and I was thinking maybe this is fitting exactly in the middle of my little piece, and it really does. It keeps a little piece on the upside, on the top open, and a little bit on the bottom open, which will be great for when you have your lights on. It will peek through it. So I think I am going to glue a little piece of this black ribbon inside of it, at least in the middle of my container. So I'm going to do that, and then we're going to look like how it will how it is with the lights on, if it looks okay still. So I'm going to glue this, and like I said, this one is also ordered online on AliExpress for 57 cents, so for 5 yards, so that's a great deal. So if you're looking for ribbon, just go look over there. I'm going to glue this on top of my container. This is how my little container is turned out, and I am really loving the black velvet ribbon. And of course you see here I have a battery pack with my lights, and you see already this is really a really a big black box. But of course you have boxes which are smaller and transparent, but I am loving this light a little bit better. I show you, they are more a little bit of the yellow color, and I like that color a little bit better than the bright lights, but that's just a taste for me. If you like the bright lights better or a color, you can do whatever you like. This is just my preference, if I say it okay. What I'm going to do right now, I'm going to do the battery packets down on the bottom, and then I'm going to do the lights on top of it, and then we are going to decorate it just simply with a couple of I think I will use some lambs here and some lavender, if I am correct, and maybe some berries, we will see. But I keep it very neutral because I am really loving this for the summertime. So I'm going to do it on the bottom, and then we're going to do a couple of branches inside of here. So you see how he is looking like right now. I hope I don't keep him too high. You see here, I have some pieces of lambs here, and I already did cut out little pieces of the branch because they were a little bit too long. I ordered this also recently on AliExpress, and they were 79 cents each, and of course you have to pay for this one because these are a little bit of the better lambs here. You have to pay a little bit of the sending cost, but this is I think only also a couple of I think it's from 90 cents or something. So of course I use four of them in each corner. I will place them beside the battery pack, and of course one over here just also in the corner, and I have the last one also again in the corner. So you see, just with some four lamps here, you already have a nice piece. And you know, I think when I saw it right on YouTube, you can get the lamps here also with the Dollar Tree or Dollarama. So a lot of you are probably even more cheaper than I can find them. So if you find them by Dollar Tree, just go ahead. I wish we had it, but we don't. But I am already lucky with AliExpress. You see here, I use the white lavender. At least it's also from AliExpress. You would say I would. You almost would say I did get paid by AliExpress, but I don't. I just want you to know that there is something. If you like to order online, you can still find nice things for a great price. So go check it out. And of course, I have to work a little bit with it because I'm sitting with my battery pack. So I have to work a little bit with it. And I'm just going to do one over here. And you see where the light is coming nicely through. And what I'm going to do at the end, I am showing you this one. These are the berries I also ordered a while ago. I'm putting them together. I just fold them over, and I'm just placing one in the middle just for a little bit, a pop of color. So I just have to place it inside. I have to need to do it a little bit shorter. And you see how easy it is just to make a little simple display, and I think it looks so nice. So I hope you can see it on camera, and of course in a moment I show you how he is turned out. So now our little container is done. I was missing something, and I'm always loving a little piece of a little tag or something else. I found these two in my stash, and they are two wooden tags, and I am loving the shape of it, and he is totally fitting with my container, the size. So I had this already laying also in my stash because I always print too much out. So I am going to use the red and white plaid, and I'm going to do it on the front and on the back side. Mod Podge it on top of it, and then I'm going to do with the black velvet, I'm going to make a little bow on top, and I'm just going to hang it on my container. And this time I'm not going to make a sign or write something on top of it. I just leave it very neutral, just a little pop of the red and white plaid. So I'm going to cut it out, everything. I'm going to Mod Podge it because I think you already know how to Mod Podge. So I'm going to finish this one, and then I show you how they are looking like. Here you see my little tags with the white and the red plaid on it, and a little bow with the black velvet and a little piece of twine, of course. I'm going to attach it to my container and then I show you the end result. So you see how my little cute container turned out. I have him on my kitchen counter, and you see my kitchen counter is not very big. Here in the Netherlands, kitchen counters are not that big. So you see here, I love this little small space. And I have my tray on the back side with my already with the lettering on it, because I made this a couple of videos back from Scrapwood. So if you want to see how I made this tray, just go check it out. And you see here, I did my little container on the front with the lights, and especially in the evening it looks great. You see here my big face I already have in many, many colors you can imagine of. Some old spoons, wooden spoons, I already painted, and I also just glued them to my back space of my kitchen. Of course, not with real glue, before we get mixed up. It is with sticky gum. Yeah, I think you call it that way. Here you see my little muffins and my dress jars, and I am really happy. If I go a little bit lower, you can see a little bit the lightning of my container, because it's very bright here, it's very difficult to see. But you see here, this is just a little display how you can do it inside of your kitchen. If you have a little bit of a small space left, just make a one container. And before we go further to our second DIY, I have to tell you that this video is also part of a challenge, which is called the Twine It Up Challenge. And the Twine It Up Challenge is hosted by the beautiful Fanny from Creations by Favi. And of course, this time as a co-host, she has the Jamie from the Crafty DIY Guy. So go check it out. I have for both of the channels, I have a link down below in my description box. And also for the playlist, I have a link down below. So go check out every beautiful creator who is joining. And of course, like I always say, let's jump into our second DIY. Here you see what we will use for our second DIY, and of course this DIY will be a three piece, because there are three in this package and I'm going to use all three of them. I'm going to paint them. They are, if you don't know, they are, you can use them for your putting your pants or something which is hot, you can use them for under it. Here in the Netherlands we call it onderzetter, a totally different word than you use. So I'm going to paint all three of them first, and I'm going to paint one in the dark blue, in the red, and one in the white, and then later on I show you what we're going to do more. But first I'm going to paint them. So you see already I have the first one. I will paint in the, like I said, in the dark blue. I mix this on my own, because I don't have the great dark blue, and for me especially is important that I do the sides, because you will see the sides. The back, you don't have to paint the back if you don't want to. It's just what you want, but I'm going to do the sides and the top, and then we're going to do the next in the red and one in the white, like I said earlier. So I'm going to paint all three of them and then I show you how they are looking like. So here you see all three of them painted, and I'm going to start with the blue one. I'm going to try to make something for the 4th of July. I found in my stash, I also printed out a while ago the American flag, and didn't use this one. So I'm going to use this one. I'm going to cut it out, and we are going to mud pot it in the middle of our round. And then later on we're going to use our twine, but first I'm going to mud pot this in the middle of it. You see already how it's looking like. I have this one cut out, and I still also found a little extra one of the sign I made a couple of videos back. So I'm going to use this middle piece, the Happy 4th of July. I'm going to cut it out, and then we are going to use this also for in our flag. At least I'm going to try to use it. I hope this is not too boring for you to see me cutting a little piece of my picture, but I just wanted to show you a little bit what I mean. So I have to cut out this a little bit, and of course I still have to cut it out a little bit better, but I just wanted to show you what I'm going to do. So, and then we are going to mod podge it on top of each other. So you see how he's looking like right now, and of course he's very plain, I know, but now we are going to work with our twine. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a line over here, and I'm going to start over here just a couple of centimeter off my picture, and then I'm going to turn it around as much as I can until here, because everything here will be in the twine, and I do on the underside the same. So I'm going to do my first turn. I'm going to do, if I have to run it out a little bit, and this way. So I'm going to start over here, because I can't start on the back side, because I don't exactly know where my start will be. So I'm going to do a little piece over here, and just laying my rope inside of here, and just wait a moment until he's stuck, so I know exactly that this is 1 centimeter from my picture. And now I can work the rest away on the back side. So I'm just going to glue my little piece just a centimeter away from my picture, at least. That's what I'm going to try, and I'm doing the same way on this side, and then I can work everything. I have to turn it around a little bit to see that I am totally like 1 centimeter of my picture. And you see, just lay your twine inside of your glue and just wait a moment, like I see. Already I'm under my glue, and now we are going to the back side, and now we can glue it together, because the back side is not the problem, but now at least we have a straight line over here. And now I'm going to turn it around just like everything is full with twine, and I'll show you that in a moment. So here you see the base of my 4th of July is finished. I will later on will decorate it completely, but for now I'm going to do the second one, and the second one will be in the red color. First I'm going to do is just take one piece of this print. I'm going to measure it out, just draw a line around it, and just do the front. I will do with the white and the red plaid, and then I'm going to, with this print, the tulips, I'm going to cut everything out in the small, and I've just that I got 3 tulips, and this one I will place in the middle of my around. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to measure this one out and cut it out, and then I'm going to mud podge it on top of it. So you see already, I changed my mind. I did cut out my round, but I didn't like it. So I am going to have a stripe in the middle. I'm going to mud podge this on top of my round. And then I'm going to do some twine over here and over here. And in the middle we will get something. I don't know if it will be the tulips or something else, because I am not sure yet, because I cut it out and I didn't like it. So with crafting also things can change. So I'm going to mud podge this on top of it, and then we are going to do some twine around it. So you see, I have the middle, I have already mud podge on top of it. What I'm going to do right now is just going to do a couple of turns, not the complete piece over here. I'm just doing a little piece of maybe 1 or 2 centimeters. And that will be it. So only a couple of turns, not a lot. So I will do that from here and over here, and then I will be back with you. So here you see already a little bit of the base of the red one, and I should do the tulips inside of it, but like I said, I didn't like it, so I'm going to my computer and I'm going to make something of my own fitting for in here, because I like that a little bit more. Because if I don't like it, I will never like it. So I am going to make something for in between, and then I will be back with you to show you what I made. Yes, I am already back with you with the same piece. I was thinking about this, and I really, not only the picture I didn't like, but I even have the color combination is not really my thing. So if you like it, it's okay too if you use this color, but I am going to paint it in the black color. I think the color will contrast a little bit better with my picture. I made a picture with some popsicle sticks. So I am ice popsicle sticks, they're only the little sticks, but I mean the totally ice. And of course I will cut it out and mud patch it on top of here, and then with the black it looks a little bit more coming out. So I am really loving that a little bit better. But if you like this color, if you like a brighter red, everything is fine. This is just my preference, so I'm going to paint it black. You see already how far he is right now. I painted it black, and of course the little sign on top of it, and I am really loving it so much more. It pops so much better than the dark red. What I'm going to do right now, the base from this one is standing, the base from my 4th of July is standing. What I'm going to do right now, I'm going to busy with the white round. So I'm going to look for what I'm going to do with that one. So, but these two are already finished. We have to finish them off, but we do that later for all three of them. So, but now we're going to do with the white one. Here you see what I did in the middle of my round. I measured out exactly the middle of this piece, and of course then 2 centimeters this way and 2 centimeters this way, and I just made a line with my pencil. And what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to paint this piece in the middle. I'm going to paint it black, because later on I will do here some twine over it, because this will be a little memory board you can hang in your kitchen or something, with just little small messages on top of it, but not a big one, just a nice one for on your bedroom or something else, or for your children, just a little simple, a little memory board. So I'm going to paint this in the black color, and then we're going to do the lines for our memory board. So you see already I have the black line on top of it, and what I'm going to do, because you see already it's not a straight line, don't worry, I hope that that it will work out. I have to use some twine, and then I'm going to make some lines over here. So don't worry, but first this has to dry. So my paint is dry, and what I'm going to do right now is just make the first line over the end of my little piece of it that I painted, so I get a straight line. So I'm going to glue in one row over here, so I can lay down my rope, and then I hope that he will be a little bit more straight than he was. And of course I have to put him down a little bit to give it the straight look. So you see, this is what I mean. And of course I'm going to also do the underside, and I'm going to do, I think, 2 in the middle. So we have 4 pieces. So because this one I have to glue, and the middle one I leave open, because you have to pin something on top of it. But I have to this time, I have to do it, glue this time. So I'm going to glue this one, and the next will be open. So this is better, because else you don't understand it anymore. So I will do it now, and I show you then. Here you see how he is looking like right now. So you see the 2 pieces I glued on top of my round, and the 4 of them, they are loose, and I have on those little wasp pins. So I will cut out a little pieces, little cards from I think maybe 3 or 4 centimeters, and I will do them on top of here. This is just a mini memory board. So what I'm going to do right now is just, I think I'm going to do a line from twine around here just to give it a little bit more structure. And I printed out one with Be Kind, and I'm going to do this on the underside. And the other one will be memo board, and I will glue this one, but put this one on the top side. So this is what I'm going to do right now. So I'll be back in a moment. So you see, this is how my memory board already turned out. So you see already, you saw the last thing you saw, I did the twine over here, and here you can do some little cards on it. I did 3 layers of rope over here. I mud podged the memo board over here, and here Be Kind. What I'm going to do right now is just from an old piece of cardboard, I'm just going to make 4 little cards for to hang on your memo board. So I'm going to cut this one out, and then we're going to attach them to our memo board. And of course, I use a little bit of the brown color, but you can also use a white cardboard, something you want. And I want to leave it also in this color because I love a little bit of the cardboard touch on it. So I'm going to make 4 of them. So here you see already, we are going to do now the top of our rounds. And what I'm going to do, I already did some preparation before you were on, because or else it will take much too long. I took a piece of ribbon with the stripe, and of course I'm turning it around in the neutral red color, and I did a little buffalo check on top of it. What I'm going to do is I'm gluing this on the top of my around, a little bit in the middle and a little bit sideways. I also do this with the other part, and I'm just going to lay it also sideways and just work a little bit the way you like it the best. And I took some pieces of my branch. You see here the branch I used. We call it Hertshoorn. I don't know how you call it. I have heard it on one of the videos I saw, but I don't remember. So we call it Hertshoorn. So I don't know how you call it, but at least I am going to glue. I have to look for which one I will have where. I'm just going to do a little piece of the end off of it, and I'm going to glue them over here on the top of our, you see here, just over here, just squeeze it a little bit and just take the other part and just, and because I always love to have a little piece of greenery inside of it. And of course, I could have used a lens here, because I ordered a lens here, and I ordered this one and another branch. But I really am liking the shape of this piece, so I'm using this one. And what I'm going to finish it off is just, I made a little bow also in the buffalo check, and I'm just gluing this on top of my, and just over the sides you don't want to see, and just squeeze it a little bit. What I'm going to do right now, because you see already, is this is a little bit too long, and I'm going to cut it on size. And and of course you can use this one if you like it a little bit longer, it's also fine. I don't really, if I am looking at it right now, I don't even know how long I want to have it, but I will keep it a little bit shorter, and of course make a little fishtail on it, and on this one the same. And I see already that I still need a little piece of branch, because I have a little piece over here, and I am going to glue one on the top, because I see already that I have a little piece over, You still can see a little bit of my bow. You see already, I am just gluing this on top of here. And I'm doing also a little piece over here. And then we are working our piece away. You just have to work with what you see. If you see pieces, they are still not quite nice. Just work away with it and give it a little bit of your own touch. So you see already, now we are working everything away. I still need to work with this. So this one also has to go this way, and this one has to go a little bit this way. But I have to look for it, how I'm going to keep it. And you see here, I have here a little gap I really don't like, and I have still a neat little piece of my, and I'm just going to give it a little, and maybe I'm just going to glue this on top of here. Now I have to look for if I like this or not. We will see. I'm sorry, I kept it out of camera. I'm sorry. So you see already, this is a little example how you can do it. Of course, you're totally free to do whatever you like. So, and now for our 4th of July sign, or just plate, just when you want to have it, you can also do it with somebody against your kitchen wall or in your kitchen. You can do it on a stand. It doesn't matter, but for this, I also made two tails. Of course, a little bit of the darker red and a little bit of the dark blue. I let it come out again. So I'm still going to glue this one just on our little bit sideways. I have to be quick because or else it will stuck already. It will stuck already on my piece. So I need to be more quick and don't talk too much. So you see already a little bit this way. Now what we're going to do, I am full of my glue. What I'm going to do is, of course, again, I'm using this one. I just take a little part of it. We do the same like we did earlier. And of course, I'm just going to cut a little piece off. So I'm going to glue this and try to do it a little bit more fast. One over here and one over here, a little bit more sideways, and just squeeze it a little bit. Then I made two loose bows. Just take a piece of ribbon, fold it together, glue it, and just do a little band in the middle. That's the easiest way you can make your own bow. So I'm going to glue the blue one on his place. So I'm just going to squeeze him over here. And I am going now to do the red color on his place. And then we're going to look for if we still miss a little part where we still need to glue some greenery inside of it. Just make your bows a little bit come out. Just squeeze the little ears. And you see already we have a little part, but I also love a little bit more on the top. So I am going to cut out a little piece of our lamb's ear again. So I'm just taking some glue, and this is just because I like it, and I'm just giving it a little touch over here, a little bit on the top. And we are going to do a little bit of this lamb's ear. Of course, my glue is always falling on me. And now we are going to squeeze this also inside of it. I hope I still do it on camera. So you see already, This is already a little part, the only thing what we still have left open again, just like our we had over here, is this way, because the bow is not the so big that he covers this. So I'm going to do a little piece also over here, and I'm just doing a little piece, and maybe not a little piece more. I say a lot of little piece. You hear me saying it, and I'm also hearing myself keep saying the words again and again. I'm sorry, bear with me. I'm doing my best, and just keep a little, and still need a little over here. I'm just gluing it, and I'm just cutting it the way I think it's okay. So don't think I am just an amateur like everyone else. I am just trying to make a nice display, but everything for me is new also. So just give you, like Olivia from Olivia Romantic Home always saying, give yourself grace. And that's I think that's a word you have to remember. Give yourself grace, because everyone is doing their best, and one person is better in it than another one. And I'm just like you, an amateur. So this is a little bit how the 4th of July sign turned out. And now the only one we still need to do is our memory board. But we have a memory board with failures. You see already, I did here my memory board. And yes, if I do my bow on top of it, you will not see nothing of your memory board. I already painted it for the first time, and I am going to paint it probably a second and a third time, and then we are going to finish this one also. So you see one of my signs, and you see already this one is the B one, which I am and didn't show you, but you see here I already was finished before I thought my camera was not running. So you see, but he's a little bit the same like the all the others. So you see, this is just for a little corner. I have him in my wooden boxes on my wall, but you can do it in one of your children's bedroom, on the wall, or something on their desk. It doesn't matter. It's just a little small one with cards on it, so you can write little nice things on it. So I am really happy how this Be Kind memo board is turned out. So now we are going to do our second little sign we made. So here you see our 4th of July sign. I also placed them for a moment in the same place I did the B sign. And you see already he is looking so nice. I think this is one of my favorites. Happy 4th of July. And I am really happy how this one is turned out, especially with a little bit of the color of a lamb's ear, but just with another shape. So I am really loving this one, and just so simple to make. You just saw me making him and how easy it was to make them. And you see already I also have light in my display, so in the evening it looks very nice. So this was my second. So, and here you see the third one. This is really a summery one with Hello Summer on top of it. And I am so happy that I painted the top and the bottom in the black color. And especially with the buffalo check and the right, the red, it pops really. So I am really happy with this one, especially around this season. So I am really happy how all three of them turned out. So I hope you just get inspired just to make from some old pen corks you have laying around. You just make one of your own. This is so easy to do. Even I can do it, so you can do it also. So I hope you just had fun watching. Yes, already you thought she is gone, but no, she is not gone yet. I just wanted to give you a quick look on my table, how they turned out in a little bit of a better light. I hope you just had fun watching and saw how easy it was to make one of them. So I hope you're going to try. But now, for now, you are finished with me. I hope to see you next time.
So this was already our new DIYs. We hope you just had fun and take a little bit of inspiration with you. Diane and I are always so thankful that you take a little piece of your day to watch a little bit of our video. So thank you all for that. And of course, if you like this content and you like I always say, a little bit of chaos, we hope you will consider subscribing to Diane and my channel. We wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and take care of each other. And we hope to see you in our next video. Love from Diane and me. Bye, everyone.